of workshop on applications of SPSS. Today we will learn about test of difference, correlations, test of variance, regression analysis. Can you hear me, all of you? Can you just type yes? Is it clear, my voice? Yeah, okay, done, yeah. Very well, now, yeah. So, we'll start.
Hello everybody,
yeah.
If you have any questions, from previous session, you can quickly ask, we can take them up in the question answer session. We'll just wait for 2 more minutes and we'll start at 7:35.
These are some very common tests you need for any research. And if you can learn it, you can analyze your data up to the highest level. And after learning this, you can also try for learning a number of other statistical tests, which I'm not taking because time constraints, but you can do it now after learning this. Shall we go? Yeah. Now,
you're going to demonstrate, right, sir?
Well, the first slides, you know, few slides.
Yes,
then.
Yes.
Yeah.
Just start that.
Okay, right. Now, we'll start our session. Learning objectives of this session. On completion of this session, you would learn about application of t-tests, coefficient of correlations, analysis of variance, and regression analysis. We'll start with measures of difference, that is t-tests. Types of t-tests. There are two types basically. One sample test. Two sample t-tests. Under two sample t-tests, we have two tests again. T-test for independent samples. B, t-test for paired samples. T-tests are used to assess significance of difference based on means. First of all, we'll take up again one sample t-test. One sample t-test is applied to examine if the difference between a sample mean and population mean or a known or hypothesized value is statistically significant. Say for example, as a researcher, you have come to know that the average monthly salary of employees the population from where you are going to pick up the sample is ₹25,000. The question would be that, and you wish to know if average monthly salary of your sample differs from average monthly salary of employees, that is the population, you need to apply one sample t-test. The hypothesis is sample average monthly salary does not differ from average monthly salary of the population. Now from SPSS, if we want to apply one sample t-test, choose from main menu, analyze, compare means, one sample t-test. Click on it. You will get one sample t-test dialog box. Select monthly salary and transfer it to test variable box. Here is a monthly salary. And if you highlight and click here or double click this, it will go into text, we'll call it test box. So monthly salary of sample has gone to the test box. Now, we enter 25,000, which is the average salary of the population, into test value box. Below this big box, you have a small box, enter 25,000. That means we are comparing the sample average and population average to examine if they differ significantly. Click OK. And here you have SPSS output. See that? It's very simple in SPSS and very fast. First, it gives you the information about the variable. And you can see that the mean of the sample, mean average salary of the sample, that is 160 people we have taken, it is 25,795. Now, as a researcher, you want to know whether this average of sample, your sample respondents, differ from population average monthly salary, that is 25,000. So this value is compared with the population mean. And then applying the test, now we go to this significance value. And we have to note down the significance value, and then we interpret. Now significance value is 0.346. We draw inference like this. Since the significance value is 0.346, which is more than 0.05, we accept the null hypothesis. That is, sample average monthly salary does not differ from average monthly salary of the population. This is also used for knowing whether your sample is representative of the population. Now, if the sample mean does not differ significantly, we can infer that your sample is representative of the population. Now, I will demonstrate it over SPSS, and then we'll have some 2 minutes, 3 minutes break so that you can put questions. I'll demonstrate it on the program now. The SPSS software, I'm opening the file. minimized. Another file, yeah, this one. Yeah. Participants, can you see this? SPSS, I have opened it. Data editor. Can you see it? Participants?
Yes.
Okay, right. Now, see that how we get one sample t-test. We go to analyze. Compare means. Come to the propped down menu. One sample t-test. Can you see it, participants? And you click one sample t-test. You will get one sample t-test dialog box. Now, this is a dialog box for one sample t-test. Now, we are examining the monthly salary. Highlight, transfer it to test variable box. Now, it is transferred. Below that, you have a test value. Now, we want to compare this with population mean, 25,000. That's all. And then you say, okay. And here are the outputs of SPSS. The first table tells you about what is the variable you are testing. And the average of the sample is this. 25,795 rupee is the average salary of your sample respondents, 160, which is the standard deviation and all. And the second table gives you the t-test value. And we have to just come here, 0.346. And we have to interpret, as I have told you, it is more than 0.05. So we say that we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Or we accept the null hypothesis means there is no significant difference between the sample average monthly salary and population average monthly salary. Now we'll have just 2-3 minutes break where you can question. If you have any doubt, you can just try. It's very simple. One sample t-test. Or you can just type clear. It's no doubt. So that we'll move forward. Okay.
For Raja, it is clear.
Good.
Simanshu is asking, sir, as a researcher, can we use one sample t-test?
Yeah. Researcher has to use.
This is for research.
Yeah. To know how representative your sample, this is a very good test.
Alif is asking, sir, can you repeat t-test once again in brief? I could not see some PPTs getting into a problem.
He wants to repeat the PPT or SPSS?
Alin.
PPT or SPSS demonstration?
In short, if you could just run through PPT.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, minimized.
Yeah.
PPT is minimized.
Yeah. See, here, quickly, you can just see the PPT. We will learn t-test, coefficient of correlation, analysis of variance, regression. There are two types of t-test, one sample and two sample. In two sample, there is a t-test for independent sample and t-test for paired sample. We apply to examine if the difference between a sample mean and population mean is statistically significant. Suppose you have got a data for your population, say employee salary of the whole factory 25,000, and you wish to know that if your average monthly salary of respondent, sample respondent, differs from the average salary of the population. So we test the hypothesis. Sample average monthly salary does not differ from average monthly salary. Pick up, analyze, compare means one sample test. In the one sample t-test dialog box, select the variable, that is say monthly salary of respondent, transfer it to the test variable box, enter 25,000 in the test value and click OK, and you will get the SPSS output. You just check this significance level. It's a 0.346. It's a more than 0.05. So accept the null hypothesis. Means there is no significant difference between the sample average salary and population average salary.
Is that before data collection or after data collection?
Yeah, after data collection, Himanshu.
Quickly again point out, sir. Analyze and
okay. SPSS. Okay. SPSS. Analyze. Compare means one sample test. We want to test by monthly income. Highlight, send to the test variable. Test value you type 25,000 and say okay. And you get the result. Here is the result. One sample t-test result. Significance value is 0.346. We'll move forward. Now we will take up t-test for independent samples. Now, two sample tests we are starting. Suppose we wish to test the following hypothesis. There is a significant difference in the satisfaction scores of male and female respondents. To test the hypothesis, we have to apply t-test for independent samples. The data file you have seen is a study called Satisfaction with Life, where there are 160 respondents. Out of this, there were 90 males respondent and 70 female respondents. To test if there is a significant difference in the life satisfaction scores of male and female respondents, we need to divide the sample, that is 160, into two groups. We also call it sub-samples. Group 1, sample of male respondents, we have coded male as 1. Group 2, sample of female respondent, was coded 2. We call these sub-samples independent samples, because there is no logical relationship between the responses of male and female respondents. To get the t-test for independent samples, from menu choose analyze, compare means independent sample t-test. Click independent sample t-test. You will get independent sample t-test dialog box. Select satisfaction with life scores and transfer it to test variable box.
Can we apply Z test here, sir?
Yeah, we can. But it is for the large sample we apply Z test. Same, it's similar to T test. But for the large sample we apply and transfer it to the test variable, life satisfaction we have sent here. Select gender and transfer to the grouping variable. Here you can see below this test variable box, we have here grouping variables.
Maximize that.
We can.
We can run it inside.
Yeah. Now we select gender. Satisfaction of life we have selected and transferred it to the test variable box. Then we select gender and we transfer to grouping variable box. There's a small box here, we transfer gender. Means you highlight and click here and it will come here. Then click define groups. Below the value bar variable box, we have define groups. Click here. This click here. And you will get a define groups dialog box. This is a dialog box for the define groups. Type one in the first box called group one box. Type two in the group two box. Exactly here, what we are doing is we are dividing the sample 160 respondents into two groups, male respondent one group, female respondent another group. So by giving this instruction, SPSS will identify all male respondents, make it group one, all female respondents are group two, then it will compare their satisfaction with life scores. And if you click here, okay, on main menu, you will get the value for t-test for independent sample. There are two tables. First table, you will get group statistics, which tells you here the 90 males and 70 female respondent. It has divided into two subsamples. For male, the average score for life satisfaction is 19.22. For female, the average score is 20.82. And this is standard deviation, this. Now, there is a difference, no doubt, but we have to examine whether statistically it is significant. So for that, the second table we have to refer, and straight we'll go to this column called significance. And here the value is 0.002. And same rule applies. The test results show that the exact value of the significance is 0.002, which is less than 0.05. Hence, we reject the null hypothesis and accept the research hypothesis, that is, there is a significant difference in satisfaction with the life of male and female respondents. I'll switch over to SPSS and I'll demonstrate. Then if you, we'll have another 2 minutes and then you can put question if you have. We go to data file of SPSS and analyze, compare means independent sample t-test, below one sample test. Click here. Now you have independent sample t-test dialog box. Now here we have to first take the dependent variable satisfaction with life, highlight, click here. Now it will go to the test variable box. Now here you have grouping variable. And in grouping variable, as we are testing for gender, so we will take gender as a grouping variable. Moment you put here, and you can see the question mark. It is asking that how B1, what are the values you have used for the two groups? These two question marks, if you click define groups, you can see here group one, it is asking whom you want to put in group one. So we type here one, means pick all male respondents and make group one, subsample one. And in second, you type two to make the female respondent as group two. So these are now two independent samples. One sample of male respondent, another sample of female respondents. And now SPSS will examine the means of two groups that you have seen just now, 19 point something and 20, whether there is a statistically significant difference. So you say continue, then you say okay. And here you have the values. T-test, first is the group statistics, 19.22 for male, average score for satisfaction with life. And for female, 20.82 is the average score. Now to see that whether these two scores are different. We apply independent sample t-test. We go straight to the significance value. This is 0.002. Now we apply the rule, decision rule. If it is less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. 0.002 is less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis that there is no difference in life satisfaction score of male and female respondent. Hence, we accept the hypothesis that there is a statistically significant difference in life satisfaction score of male and female respondent. Now, your question.
The question was from Mr. Ross. Can we apply, when we call it a large sample?
30 is the statistician say that up 30 is a small, and any sample above that is a large sample. It depends on your experience that if you know the respondents, you have a literature review and you feel that the variance is equal. You can presume and you can take the equal variance. But generally, if you don't have information, then we have to go for unequal variance. Is it clear, Mr. Matthew? Any other question?
Yes, typing.
Yeah,
please
okay.
Take your time and type your question.
Yes.
What is equal variance assumption and not assumption?
Equal variance assumption is that among the group, say male respondent and female respondent, if we have some research literature review where we say that on life satisfaction score, the variance in male respondent, that is young male and old male, whether we have equal variance. And also among female, we have equal, means irrespective of age or education, the variance is there. And then we say equal variance, depends upon literature review. Is it clear? Will come later after that. F test, we will see three groups. We examine three groups. No more question?
Yes.
We'll move forward. Right. Our next test is t-test for paired sample. The paired sample t-test is a statistical procedure used to determine whether there is a significant difference between two sets of scores, two sets of observation. Usually in the problems we have pre and post intervention or experiment, two sets of scores. In a paired sample t-test, each respondent is measured twice, resulting in pairs of observation. For example, if a researcher wants to examine if practice of yoga affects satisfaction with life scores, he or she needs to apply t-test for paired sample. Means he or she has to record data before yoga, life satisfaction score, and after yoga training is over, researcher has to collect data. So now researcher will have two sets of data, one called pre, another is called post data. The hypothesis will be practice of yoga will not have effect on satisfaction with life of respondents. Research hypothesis would be practice of yoga will have effect on life satisfaction of respondents. To test the hypothesis, researcher has to examine if the pre and post yoga satisfaction with life scores differ significantly.
Can you give another example where we can use it, use t-test for paired sample?
Yeah, suppose you are using new teaching techniques, or the group who is listening to this workshop, we could have tested their knowledge of statistics before our starting of the course. And again, we can collect data from the participant of this course after the course is over. And if we want to know whether attending a workshop on statistics, there is improvement in the knowledge of statistics of the participant, we have to apply paired sample t-test. Is it clear? Yeah, okay, no problem.
Which hypothesis can you mention?
What is that?
Which hypothesis can mention that?
Both null hypothesis as well as research hypothesis.
Will test accommodate? Full question.
I think both are related. If you reject the null hypothesis, means you are accepting research hypothesis.
For assessing students' participation and understanding, any technique can we use t-test?
Yeah. You need to use t-test for paired sample.
Okay, so you mean alternative hypothesis can be called as a research hypothesis?
Yeah, generally it's called as a research hypothesis. But more appropriate is alternative hypothesis. Okay, we'll move. Next is correlations. test of correlations, and a very common measure is Pearson's R. Yeah. Pearson's R. Coefficient of correlation or Pearson's R is a measure of correlation between two numeric variables, X and Y, giving a value between plus 1 and minus 1, where plus 1 is perfect positive correlation, 0 is no correlation, and minus 1 is perfect negative correlation. Null hypothesis is there is no correlation between age and satisfaction with life scores. Alternate hypothesis is age and life satisfaction with life scores are correlated. From the main menu, select analyze. Then select correlate from drop-down menu. And once you click correlate, then you have another drop-down menu where you select bivariate. Click bivariate. If you click here, you will have now bivariate correlation dialog box. Now select age, the first variable, and second variable, satisfaction with life, and transfer it to the test variable box. So first you click here age, highlight age, click here, it will go in the test box. Highlight satisfaction with life, click here and it will go here, second variable. And then click OK. Pearson's R is by default, it is there already. So you can just say now OK. And you will get SPSS output. And see here in that correlation coefficient R, Pearson's R, is 0.876. And significance value is 0.00. For interpretation, we start with this significance, then we go to this. The test results show that the exact significance is 0.00, which is less than 0.05. Hence, we reject the null hypothesis, that is, age and satisfaction with life scores are not correlated, and accept the alternate hypothesis, that is, age and life satisfaction are correlated. Then we go for nature. And remember, once we get the significant value, then only we explain nature and strength. If it is not significant, you have to close there itself. Interpretation is closed. We go further only when R value is statistically significant. I hope it is clear to all the participants. So now next few slides is applicable only when R value is statistically significant. I hope it is clear. So our R value is statistically significant. Now we first explain nature of correlations. And now when one variable increases or decreases and other changes in the same direction, the correlation between the two variables is positive. But if the changes in the two variables are in opposite directions, the correlation between the two variables is negative. X increases, Y also increases. Positive correlation. X increases, Y decreases. We call it negative correlations. Now, seeing the result, the value of R has been found to be 0.876. There is no sign, so we call it positive. The coefficient of correlation is positive, which means there is a positive correlation between age and satisfaction with life. In other words, we can say that, infer that, higher the age, higher would be the life satisfaction. Alternatively, it can be concluded that older people would have higher level of satisfaction with life than younger. The second point is strength of correlation. Also, we have to interpret. The coefficient of correlation, R, changes in value from positive 1 down through 0 to negative 1. Statistical convention decrees that the coefficient of correlation ranging from 1 to 0.7 plus or minus be taken as an indication of high correlation, that ranging from 0.7 to 0.4 plus minus as substantial, 0.4 to 0.2 as low, and that below 0.2 as negligible. The value of R has been found to be 0.876. That means there is a high correlation between age and satisfaction with life. I will just demonstrate it first, then again we'll have some time. I'll take up your questions. Here is our SPSS data editor. Analyze, correlate. To get correlation coefficient, we have to come to correlate. Then you again highlight bivariate. Click. You will have bivariate correlation dialog box. Now we'll take age, numeric variables, both age and satisfaction with life. This is a numeric variable. This ladder indicates that it's a numeric variable. You can see the ladder. And we second variable also we transfer here. Then Pearson, you can see the tick mark already by default. So you have to simply say OK. And here are the results. You can see here, it's a significant 0.00, and the value is 0.876. Now, if you have a question or doubts, please type.
How should we write interpretation for negligible positive correlation?
Simply, you have to say that it is insignificant. There is no question of positive, negative strength. Forget. When it is non-significant, simply say that the correlation is insignificant and finish. That is the end of the interpretation. Nothing. Yes, please. Yeah. Sure.
Can we apply Spearman's correlation here?
No, Spearman's correlation is for non-parametric. We'll see tomorrow, I'll tell you. It's a rank values. It's not a numeric value. So we apply, if there is a numeric data, we should apply Pearson's R. If you have ranking or any other type of ordinal data, we can apply Spearman's. So we will take it up in non-parametric test.
What is the difference between parametric and non-parametric test?
We will see tomorrow. This is a part of tomorrow's session, friend. I'll explain you in very detail. Wait for tomorrow. But today we are dealing with parametric. And in briefly, I can tell you that when we know the population, we have statistics for the population, we call parametric. If we don't know about the population, we use non-parametric. There are more factors for non-parametric. We'll see tomorrow. Any other question?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
What does the word correlation and association cannot?
Yeah, it's a convention, you can say. Both are having almost similar meaning, but the conventionally, when we are applying some on a contingency table, cross table, you have seen on Friday, we call it association, like chi-square test is a test of association, whereas when we apply on numeric variables, like today, age and satisfaction, we call it correlation. Correlation word is used for numeric, like Pearson's, all.
Both seem similar.
Yeah, both are, you can say correlation, both are correlation. But just to have a kind of distinction, we use association and correlation. Okay. We'll move forward. Our next test is one-way analysis of variance. The analysis of variance, sometimes obtained as ANOVA, or F-test determines whether there is a statistically significant difference between more than two groups on the basis of their means. So three groups and above, we apply analysis of variance. Whether there is a statistically significant difference between more than two groups, statistical measure called variance is used. Variance is nothing but square of standard deviation. As such, it is called analysis of variance. But it is the extension of t-test, you can say. It's also based on means.
F-test.
Same, it's a name, just given a name, F-test for analysis of variance. just like T test. So it is F test. Suppose, any question is there? Suppose we wish to test the following hypothesis. There is a significant difference in life satisfaction scores of respondents by their marital status. The respondents are divided into three groups by their marital status. In data file, we can see we have 84 married respondents, 58 unmarried, and 18 divorced. So there are three groups. We want to examine that if there is, the three groups differ significantly on satisfaction with life. For test the hypothesis, we have to apply one-way ANOVA. When we use only one independent variable for analysis of variance, we call it factor. In SPSS also, you will get the word factor instead of independent variable, but it is exactly independent variable. To analyze the variance in one dependent variable, we call it one-way analysis of variance. From the menu, choose Analyze, Compare Means, One-Way ANOVA. Click One-Way ANOVA. You will get One-Way ANOVA dialog box. This is the dialog box. Highlight Variable Satisfaction with Life. And transfer it to the dependent list. This box is dependent list variable box, we call it. Dependent variable box is this. So select satisfaction with life. Click here, it will go to the dependent variable box. And then you select the independent variable, marital status, and transfer it to the factor box, a box titled as a factor. So highlight marital status, click here, and it will go into factor box. That's all. You click OK button, and you will get SPSS output. You can see that how easily we get the different values. And as usual, we go for significance value, we check. It's a 0.002. The test results show that the exact significance is 0.002, which is less than 0.05. Hence, we reject the null hypothesis, that is, there are no significant differences in statistic satisfaction with life of respondent with respect to their marital status. Thus, we accept the hypothesis, that is, there are significant differences in the satisfaction with life with respect to marital status for respondents. In other words, you can say satisfaction with the life of married people is different from unmarried and divorced. They are different on this parameter, satisfaction with life.
So before applying any test, whether we should test the assumptions?
Yeah, that is the probability sample. It should be random. These are the simple presumption for parametric. Random selection of the sample is the basic presumption. Is it okay? We'll go to SPSS.
For one person.
Okay. Okay.
Could you explain two-way ANOVA, sir?
We have not included because of the time constraint, but simply you can say if you are taking two variables, two independent variables to examine the variance in the dependent variable, we call it two-way ANOVA. Two independent variables. Now we are just taking one, so we call it one-way ANOVA. You can learn all those things now slowly by your own efforts. You can see that. Done?
You're going to demonstrate, right?
Yeah. Right? Now we are in SPSS. We go to analyze. Compare means one-way ANOVA. If you click here, you get one-way ANOVA dialog box. Now we select the dependent variable, the variable which you want to analyze. Satisfaction with life scores is a numeric variable. F test is applied on numeric variable. Dependent variable is numeric. And then we select the factors, the independent variable, and we have said marital status. Highlight, click this. Second arrow where the title is a factor. Click here. Now marital status has come as a factor. Means it's going to divide the sample into three groups: married, unmarried, and divorced, and we'll examine if their life satisfaction scores differ significantly. And simply you can say, okay, and you are here. One-way ANOVA results are here. And you can see here, first we go to this significance level, which is 0.002. It's less than 0.05. So we reject the null hypothesis and accept the hypothesis. That is, there is a significant difference in satisfaction with life scores of unmarried, married, and divorced respondent. Now, again, you can have any question you want to ask. You can ask.
So, any good reference books for SPSS with statistics?
There are a number of books. I mean, statistics, application of SPSS statistics by SAGE is the best book now. SAGE publication, you can. Title are same, application of SPSS or SPSS statistics through SPSS. But the SAGE people have brought one book, which is, I think, very simple and you can understand. But I would suggest you to learn with the program. That's much better than SAGE. Here only you can just go through the instruction and the PPT is there. You just get the printout. Try this. And then study, I have told you, therefore study that, go to help. And then you learn through topics, tutorial, and a statistics coach. And I'm sure you'll be very, very thorough with the whole statistical application. SAGE and all publications are good for, suppose you want to teach, you want to explain somebody then. But as a user of statistics, the best way is to learn through the program itself. And I have told you there are some data files in the system, in the program itself, and then you can open the file, get it copied, and on that file you try all these tests. You can try.
I have a PDF I would like to share with the participants. It's discovering statistics using SPSS third edition.
Mm-hmm.
So SAGE and the field.
Yeah. SAGE had 2-3 books on this. That's a very wonderful book.
Yeah. So you have a free copy. I'm putting a link up here, PDF. You can certainly download it. I just couldn't tell.
Right.
Somebody is asking what's the price of SPSS. Starting at ₹6,370 per user per month. For that also I'm putting a link up here if you would like to buy, you are welcome to do so.
Yeah.
How long do we need SPSS?
Huh?
How long do we need SPSS?
As long as you are a researcher. You want to do research, you have to be with SPSS. Right. Our next topic is regression analysis. We are reaching the top, almost top, you can say. This is the highest order of statistical procedure. Very useful. And also gradually we are moving from one variable, descriptive statistics, two variables, cross tables, contingency table, two variables, numeric, and three variables, F-test, two variables, you have T-test, chi-square, three variables. Now, we are entering into multivariate analysis. Regression is a technique, or is also known as multivariate analysis. You can take n number of variables at a time. Regression analysis is a powerful statistical procedure for analyzing relationships between a dependent variable and one or more independent variables. Regression analysis is a statistical approach to determine change in a dependent variable on the basis of change in one or more independent variable. And also you can say we can predict. We can predict the change. In order to use regression analysis, we need dependent variable and independent variable as a numeric data, and it should be ratio or interval level. That's why I said it's the highest level of measurement. The hypothesis. There is no effect of age and income on satisfaction with life. Alternate hypothesis, satisfaction with life is a function of age and income. Those who have attended our research methodology course, now you can take note of it that F-test and regression, we are testing the what's called complex hypothesis. All earlier hypothesis was simple hypothesis, up to t-test, chi-square, these are simple hypotheses. Now, if you formulate complex hypothesis, you have to apply either F-test or regression. Independent variables are age and income. Dependent variable is satisfaction with life. To obtain multiple regression, from the main menu choose Analyze, Regression, Linear. Click on Linear, Analyze, Regression. If you click Regression, you will get this side drop down menu. There you select Linear. Click on it. And you have now regression dialog box, we call it. Select the dependent variable, that is satisfaction with life, and send it to dependent variable box. The first box is known as dependent variable box. So we have transferred satisfaction with life on dependent variable box. Select age and monthly income and send it to dependent variable box. The second box is called independent variable box. Select method, and by default, the method is enter, is by default. So you have to just click on method enter here. You can just click and then you say, okay, this is a method. And by default, you have got a method called enter. Enter is the name of method. So you say, okay, and you will get the output. So there are three tables. I'll explain you one by one. The first table displayed on SPSS output viewer tells you about what are the variables entered and what is the dependent. Now this table shows that two independent variables have been entered, monthly income and age. And dependent variable is satisfaction with life total score is the dependent variable. And method enter. So this is the first information you get from the first output. Then the second output is called model summary. And here, first of all, you have to interpret R value. The R value represents the simple correlations, and which is 0.894, here you can see, which indicates a high degree of correlation between the variables. I must tell you here that you try for regression only when the variables have high correlation. If you get here low value, means it's not fit for regression. There's no hard and fast rule from where we should say no, but generally 0.7 above, you will get a good results for regression. 0.7 and below, your regression will not be a very useful values. This is the second. Third, you have to interpret R square value. This is the R square value. The R square value indicates how much of the total variation in the dependent variable, satisfaction with life, is explained by the independent variables, age and monthly income. This tells you about how much variation in the dependent variable is explained by these two variables, how much these two variables are responsible to bring change in this. And this figure tells us about the amount. And here also we have a kind of convention in social sciences. If it is 0.33 and above, it's good, we accept it. Below 0.33, I think this regression may not have a good value. Now, in this problem, we have 0.799, almost you can say 0.8. This is a good amount of variation is explained by age and monthly income. Then we have model summary. In this case, 0.79 or about 80%, we can convert this into percentage by multiplying by 100. So it's 80% of the variation in the dependent variable, satisfaction with life, is explained by independent variables, age and monthly income, which is a very large. See the picture? This much is explained. 80% is explained by age and monthly income. That is variation in life satisfaction. This much is explained by age and monthly income. 20% is still unexplained. Means we may have to find out some more variables to explain this unexplained. There is a next table is ANOVA output, and it is 0.00, means it says that the variation explained by these two is statistically significant, means this regression model is acceptable. ANOVA table reports how well the regression equation fits the data, that is, predicts the dependent variable, how much it predicts. And it's, we can say now the prediction is statistically significant. This table indicates that the regression model predicts the dependent variable significantly well. And this is the most important table of the regression. Regression coefficient table. And here, first of all, we have to see whether it is statistically significant. Then only we proceed to see the contribution of each independent variable. Now it says 0.00 for age, means contribution in explaining the variation in satisfaction of life. Age has a significant contribution. Monthly income has also a significant contribution in explaining satisfaction with life. Once these are significant, we proceed to explain this. If here we find non-significant, you have to stop there, or we have to delete. You have to just leave that variable, which is insignificant contribution. Here both are having significant contribution. Then we go further and explain this. Two value beta. Beta is a standardized coefficient, we call it. And you can see the interpretation. The coefficient table provides us with the necessary information to predict the satisfaction with life from age and monthly income, as well as determine whether these variables contribute statistically significantly to the model by looking at significance column. If it is significant, then we can prepare a model. Both variables have significant contribution in explaining satisfaction with life. The coefficient for age and monthly income are statistically significant because its p-value is less than 0.05. The results indicate that age is the most important factor to explain life satisfaction of elderly. We just go back and see the contribution, the beta. Beta tells us about what is the contribution of that independent variable age. The beta value is 0.765. And for monthly income, the beta is 0.209. So we say that age is the most important factor in explaining the variation in satisfaction with life. Followed by monthly income. Satisfaction with life is a function of age and monthly income. That means they have effect on life satisfaction, significant effect on explaining life satisfaction. And this statistical procedure helped us to develop a model. We call it a regression model. This is the general equation y equals to c plus bx, where and y is called dependent variable, c is a constant, b is a regression coefficient, x is independent variable. Now, from the coefficient table, now we can develop the model. And now this equation will have two independent variables. So we say regression coefficient 1, B1, and beta regression coefficient B2 for X1 and X2. X1 is age and X2 is monthly income. So age multiplied by beta coefficient, monthly income multiplied by beta coefficient. If you add 2 plus constant, you can predict the Y. That means this is the equation. You can see that for any sample, if you have age and monthly income, taking this equation, you can predict what will be the life satisfaction of that sample. This constant plus 0.765, that is called beta coefficient of age, plus this beta coefficient of monthly income. So multiply monthly income multiplied by 0.09209, age multiplied by 0.65. If you add these three, you can predict the satisfaction with life score of any other sample. Now I'll just demonstrate and then we'll have some discussion. This is our data table. We go to analyze, regression, then we select linear. We get the linear regression dialog box. First box, you can see dependent variable. So our dependent variable is satisfaction with life. Highlight, click here. Now it is in dependent box. Then we have decided to take age as one independent variable and income as another variable. And by default, we have method enter is there. Another method is also here, like stepwise, remove these things, or you can learn through slowly you can. But since we have by default, enter is mostly used in most of the cases. So just here, now you come to OK, and you will get the regression values. You can see the three tables. One, variables entered. Monthly income and age. Method is enter. Dependent variable is life satisfaction. R is 0.894. R square is 0.799. That is 80% explained. And you see the ANOVA says, yes, the model is acceptable. Then we go to coefficient table. And first we see the significance. If they are significant, that means this two independent variable has significant contribution in explaining the dependent variable satisfaction with life. Then we go to see the contribution of each independent variable. The contribution of age is highest, 0.76, and monthly salary plays a smaller role, that is 0.209. So age is most important factor in predicting the satisfaction with life. Yes. Now, yeah. Question.
Doubt. Some experts say we should take adjusted R square.
Yes.
Instead of R square. Yeah. What do you suggest?
Yeah. It's not some experts, but if the units of measurement of the independent variables are different, we go for adjusted R square. Here, actually, adjusted R square we should have taken. But just to avoid the complication, I have explained you the R, which is beta coefficient. When the units are same, then you can go for beta coefficient. So you can see here, results will be almost same. You can see here it is 0.016 and it has got 0.00 for, and here it you have 0.295 and 6.6 exponent 5 is a unstandardized, and we go for standardized beta. So here, because age and monthly income are two different units, So we have to take standardized coefficient beta. I hope it's clear.
When is that ready regular tables coming?
Coming next. Once you say yes, you have understood all this, then we'll come to ready regular table. Is it okay? No question?
Satisfaction with life is categorical variable, and this analysis helps to predict continuous dependent variables. How could we use this example?
No. You have missed one point. We have to take satisfaction with life scores. Always I am mentioning it. Not categorical variable. Before categorization, we have to take the scores. The regression in the first slide I have said. It is applied with a numeric variable. So age, monthly income, and satisfaction with life scores we have to use, friend. Done? Yeah, fine. Very good. Now, here is a ready recorder table. And all the statistics applications are summarized in this table. You have to get it printed, put it on your study table while you are analyzing the data. Now you can select the test on your own. You need not go to any statistician or experts. And I'll just explain you a little bit. The first column you can see, it is measurement level of first variable. And for this, I think our research methodology workshop, if you have attended, you should be familiar, or you have to get yourself familiar with this type of data, dichotomy, two variables, two, yes or no. Nominal, caste, religion, ordinal, education or attitude, interval and ratio, like age, income. So measurement level is this, one, dichotomy, nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. First, you can see the red, this column is for single variable procedure. Descriptive statistics you get, only one variable, age, you can get proportion, percentage, if it is a dichotomy. If it is a nominal, you can have proportion, percentage, and ratio. If you have ordinal, then you can have median, quartiles, quartile deviation. If the one variable is interval and ratio, you can have mean, median, standard deviation. This is for one variable analysis, descriptive statistics. Then we come to two variable, or we call bivariate procedures. What you have learned today. So here also we have dichotomy by dichotomy. We can use chi-square or phi. Two variables. First is dichotomy. Second is also dichotomy. You can use chi-square phi. First variable is, say, first nominal. Second is dichotomy. You can use chi-square. First variable is interval. Second variable is dichotomy. You can use difference of mean test. Today you have seen gender and satisfaction with life. First variable is dichotomy, nominal. Second variable is nominal. Then most appropriate is chi-square. Nominal, ordinal by nominal, you need analysis of variance with ranks. Interval ratio with nominal, no. Then we go for here. Ordinal by ordinal. The test are rank order, correlation, and gamma. Then you have dichotomy by interval. Interval and interval. Both variables are interval and ratio. Interval and ratio, you can apply analysis of variance today, F-test, interclass, correlation, and regression. So we call regression as the highest level. Both the variables must be interval or ratio. Yes, please. Any question you can ask? Any question is there coming? Yes, no problem.
Where do we use phi test?
Phi test we use when we have dichotomy by dichotomy. Both the variables are in yes, no. Marital status, say married, unmarried, and something you have asked, whether you have gone for family planning operation, yes, no. So you can apply phi. Both the variables are in dichotomy. Married, unmarried, and here it is yes, no. This is called phi.
How to test the difference assumptions of regression analysis?
What do you mean by that? Difference assumption means?
A question from Subhanshu. How to test the difference assumptions of regression analysis?
Now, can you elaborate? What do you mean by assumption? Assumption is the criteria for selecting the variable. We don't test assumptions. And the assumption is that variables are numeric, interval and ratio. What else you want to know? And one assumption is also there.
Linearity,
yes.
Linearity.
Yeah. So linearity is the assumption that we presume that independent and dependent variable will change in a straight line equation. It will follow equation, or we have collinearity, another equation we use. These are the presumptions. Yes. Yeah. Okay, no problem.
We want to test interval to nominal variables, which test we apply?
Interval and nominal. There's no specific test. But lower test can be used, you know, not the higher test. For example, one is interval and the nominal, you can use chi-square. The chi-square can be used, you know, chi-square can be. It's actually best test for nominal binomial, but in case you want to have interval and nominal, we can use chi-square. lower tests can be applied, not the higher test. You cannot have any test of this area. If your data is a nominal and interval, you have to come within this. Any more question is coming? Yeah. So now we'll one more help. I will just demonstrate to you. You can just see that. In addition to the main menu help, topic, tutorial, and statistics coach, I'll show you one more that also you can learn today. And if you want to practice, you can practice. Now, for example, suppose you want something, say, quick help you want. Suppose you want to know about, say, for example, beta. You want to know about what is beta, for example. Okay. So now what you have to do is that just double click it. And why it is coming, I don't know. See, we have highlighted it. Now it's activated. We call it, the table is activated. Now, whatever you want to know, you click at that point and right click. And then you go up. What is this? Click it. And you will have immediate explanation of that. What is beta coefficient? It's just here. This is also very useful now. After learning almost all the statistics, this is all quick information. Tutorial, statistics coach are elaborate explanation. Quick explanation you get, shortcut explanation is here. Again, I'll explain you another one. Suppose you have forgotten about R square and you want to know. Now you highlight, activate it. It's activated. Now you want to know about R square, highlight it, right click. What is this? And now you have information about what is R square or R or adjusted R, anything you want, double click, then click that part and the right click, click what is this? And you will have the explanation. There is also very important tip. While learning SPSS, you can use this. So you will know immediately what is this. Later, you can go for tutorial, statistics coach to have elaborate information about that. I hope you got this. Done. Fine, I think. We'll sum up now. If there is no question, we can sum up. T-tests are used to assess significance of difference between two numeric variables. Pearson R is a measure of correlation between two numeric variables, X and Y. The analysis of variance, or F-test, determines whether there is a statistically significant difference between more than two groups. Regression analysis is a procedure for analyzing relationship between dependent variable and one or more independent variables. It is an approach to determine change in a dependent variable on the basis of change in one or more independent variables. Frequently asked question, differentiate paired sample t-test and independent sample. What is negative correlations? What is the major purpose of regression analysis? Difference between pair and independent sample. While in independent sample t-test, there are two samples. Independent of each other, Whereas in a paired sample t-test, each subject or respondent is measured twice, resulting in pairs of observation or data, commonly we call pre and post. When the changes in the two variables are in opposite direction, x is increasing, y is decreasing, the correlation between the two variables is called negative correlation. Main purpose of regression analysis is to determine change in a dependent variable on the basis of change in one or more independent variables. End of session, we'll have a quiz now. In session 4, we'll learn about non-parametric tests.
Before we end the screen, sir, is there any other thing that you would like to do?
No, today is over. Yeah. Very fast. T-test is applied for numeric variables, right? Yeah, it's very right. Determines more than two variables, right? And third is R-square value indicates how much of the total variation in the dependent variable can be explained. Very right. Most of the people have got it. Very good. Today's response is the best. Yeah. The first question, 79% people are correct. 73% and 82%. Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. Very difficult session today. And you have answered all the three questions much better than the previous sessions. Everyone, almost only few people.
Is there any question that you have before we end the session? Participants, any questions? All right, thank you very much, all of you, for joining us tonight. Now we will see you tomorrow.
Yeah. Wonderful.
Sure. Please take care of yourself. Good night.
Night.